Bonjour à tous et bienvenue sur ma chaîne. Si c'est votre première fois, je m'appelle Nsongrewili. Afin d'améliorer mon français que j'ai partagé plus tôt, je vais commencer mes vidéos avec un peu de français comme ceci. I am an international student in France. I share content on master's application, my life as an international student in France and other useful content. Si c'est le genre de choses que vous aimez, abonnez-vous, partagez et aimez mes vidéos. Merci à vous. Okay guys, in this video, I'll be sharing with you some fully funded scholarships in France. And in the course of this video, I want you to take note of three important things. First being the timeline of the scholarship, like when do they normally start the scholarships, the opening date and the closing period too. The second thing I want you to take note of is the criteria. What are the criteria? Do you meet up to them or what can you do to meet up to the criteria? And then what are the cost areas that these scholarships cut across? I need you to take note of these three things so that in the next application timeline, you'll be well prepared for the application. I'm wishing you all the best. So guys, the first one we'll be looking at is Eiffel Scholarship Program of Excellence. That is the first one we'll be looking at. So as you can see, the call of applications is open until January, and for the one of 2022, it was January 7th. That means for the one of 2023 session is going to end around January 2023. And what is the start date? The opening call application starts around September, and for this 2023 to September 27, so you should take note of the timeline. It will be safe for us to say that the opening is from September to January, late September to January. So take note of this, and then the result is normally published around April, as you can see here. And unfortunately for this one, for the master's level, it has age limit being 25 years of age. So that means if you are above 20, like you are 26, then you can't apply for it, unfortunately. And for the PhD also, it has age limit, which is 30 years of age. And then for the regulation, it's by the Eiffel program guide, and you can come here to get more details. Say you're a student interested in participating in the Eiffel program, click here. So you can click here to find more information on what it is and how you should go about it. So here you can see the areas of study for science and technology, for humanities and social sciences. So people that you want to study French language actually can apply for this. And then the levels of study for your master's degree, engineering program, and your doctoral. Then this is the duration. You have the duration for master's level being 12 months. That's if you're enrolling in M2, that is the final year of the master's program. 24 months if you are enrolling for M1, because like I've mentioned in previous videos that the master's in France is 2 years. And then for an engineering degree is 36 months, that is 3 years. And then if a doctorate, it's only for 12 months. That means, I think maybe for a doctorate, that means you have to be applying each year. That's what I think, because normally for doctorate degree it's 3 years, but for this one, that means you have to be applying every year for the doctorate arm of the scholarship. And this is the step for you to apply for this scholarship. The first step is for you to contact Campus France in your country. So you can, if you're in Nigeria, you can contact Campus France Nigeria, or you are from Kenya, whatever country you're from, just contact Campus France in your specific country. And then it's up to you to choose the school or university that best fits your plans for studying in France. And you also learn about the procedure and deadlines for submitting. And also, like it's being said here, applications sent by students or by foreign institutions will be considered ineligible, because applications can be sent only by the school. Only applications submitted by French higher education institutions are accepted. So it's not your responsibility to submit this application. Your own responsibility is to first reach out to Campus France Nigeria to ask about how you can apply for this scholarship, or you reach out to this particular school you want to apply to, because it's the French higher education that can apply, like that can send your application to the Eiffel program. So you can get more on this. I'm going to drop the link on the description for you to check it out and get more information on it. And you can always email your school to ask about if they're part of this program. That is it for Eiffel Scholarship Program of Excellence. And the next scholarship we'll be looking at is France Excellence Europa, the Excellence Scholarship to study in France. You can just call it Excellence Major Scholarship. That's how some people call it, Excellence Major Scholarship. So for this particular one, it's actually for European students. So if you're an European student and you wish to continue your master's in France, it's actually like maybe an exchange program. So it really doesn't concern people outside of the European community. It's mostly for Europeans. So if you are one of my subscribers and you are in Europe, or you're an European citizen, you can apply for this scholarship, and you can see like the benefits you're going to get from it, the exemptions and the health insurance and different other things. So for you to get more on this one, you can check on my description to receive the link and learn more about this one. The third scholarship we'll be looking at is the Erasmus scholarship. So for Erasmus scholarship, it's actually like a joint master's scholarship, because it allows you to travel to different countries in Europe. So you don't have to do like a master's in only one country. Like I said, the master's is 2 years, so per semester you are obligated to do it in like a different country. And then for each program, they have their different locations that they do the master's. So let's look at this website, the catalog. This is the catalog for the Erasmus Mundus. And they have like over 163 catalogs. And for example, look at this course, Master Science in Coastal and Marine Engineering. It shows you like the location: Norway, France, Spain, Italy. And then this link will lead you directly to the program for you to know more about like the admission process and everything that you need to apply for that particular program. So I'm going to drop this website on the description for you to know more. So you choose your program here. There are a lot of programs that up to 163 of them. 163 of them. So you look at the program and then you look at the different locations that is offering your program. And when you click on the website, it leads you the website for the specific program. It leads you for you to check out the admission timeline and so on. So I advise that you look for it now, because some of these Erasmus scholarships, some of them will start maybe in September or October, but mostly they last up to like February of the next year for the scholarship. So look at this also. So the next scholarship we're looking at is Emile Boutmy scholarship. For this particular scholarship, when I tried checking like the official website, I did not see anything on it, but I was opportune to see this on another website. So for this scholarship, it's actually cut across undergraduate, graduate and PhD programs. And then for the one of 2023, it's already elapsed. If you check the scholarship summary here, you're going to see the institution that sponsors this scholarship is actually Sciences Po. That is the institution that sponsors it. Yeah, Sciences Po is actually a big school in France. It's one of the top schools in France here. And it stated here that the students can enroll in any subjects offered by the university. So it's going to now be your job for you to go to the university website to see the courses that they offer. Which of them do you like? So it also shows you here the deadline. For example, for the master's program, it's around November of that the previous year. So if you're applying for now 2023, it's going to end November 2022. So you can set a time, a reminder on your phone or anywhere you want to set it, that from September you should start looking at Sciences Po to see if they've put on the website about the Emile Boutmy scholarship, or if you're applying to a specific program, they be it undergraduate, master's or PhD. It also shows that for the undergraduate, you can the deadline lasts up to like the next year of the scholarship. That is for 2023, it's going to be like around February. And then it shows you like what the scholarship covers. So the scholarship is like a tuition grant per year, a tuition grant depending on undergraduate, if it's undergraduate or master's. So let's look at the master's arm of it. So it gives you a grant of 10,000 euros to cover your tuition fees for the two masters. So that means that it's not like a tuition exemption. They give you the money yourself, and depending on if the money actually covers for your school fees, because if you are going to the school and your school fees is like a year, 10,000 for a year. That means this will not cover for everything. It's just going to be like a partial scholarship for you. So you should take note of that. You should take note if the scholarship gives you like an exemption totally, or they will just give you the money for you to pay. So when they give you the money, it doesn't matter if it's more or less than. So let's say you're going to school that you have to pay like 2,000 and the scholarship is giving you 5,000. It's a plus for you. But if you're going to school that costs more than 10,000 and the scholarship gives you 5,000 per year, then you have to look for other means to cover up for your school fees. So you should take note of that when you're looking out for scholarships. And it also shows you the eligibility, like I said, the criteria. And its required language is English. So I guess that means you're going to look for an English dot course. I think so. And then the eligible countries is all world countries, no matter where you are from. You're eligible to apply for these scholarships. And it shows you the people that are not eligible. So you just have to go through this to see if you're eligible or not. And then how to apply for it. So like I said, when I checked the official school website, I did not find this scholarship at the moment. So I don't know if it's because it is already elapsed, that's why. So you should just put it on your calendar or anywhere you remind that to check from September. You go to Sciences Po and see if they still have a scholarship available, Emile Boutmy scholarship. The next scholarship we'll be looking at is the one offered by Université Paris-Saclay. And this scholarship is the IDEX scholarship. So for the IDEX scholarship, most schools actually do this, even for University Grenoble apps, they do this too. For this one, you're just like the Eiffel Scholarship, you're not the one to apply for it. It's a school that automatically shows if you are eligible for the scholarship. So in most of them, when you're applying, they ask you, are you interested in applying for IDEX, and you tick the box. And if you're eligible, they're going to send you either a congratulatory message or sorry, you're not awarded the scholarship, that kind of stuff. So for this Paris-Saclay, let's look at it. And for the academic year of 2022-2023, it's already like elapsed, like it's over already. So let's say the one of 2023, it's going to be like, you can see here, the timeline. Remember I said no to the timeline. So the timeline for the masters is around 28th April. So that means for 2023, it's going to elapse around 28th April 2023. But I think for this one, maybe you have to like get admission first into the school, or maybe you should apply to the school first. So it's advisable that you go to the website to see like the courses they offer, if you like it, the ones that are taught in English, or if you speak French, the ones that you meet up to the criteria, apply for it, and then the school will automatically put you in for the scholarships. But like it's been said here, that admission to the master's program does not automatically entitle students to a scholarship. You should take note of that. It's a competition, so just because you admit it doesn't mean you're entitled to a scholarship. It will just be checked if you meet up to the criteria depending on the competition that you have with you. And then the deadline for you to receive the scholarship is 14th May, and deadline to the recommendation and closing is 18th May. I think it's only like recommendation later, I think. And the result is normally announced June. So that is it for this one. So like I said, it's not you. You're not the one meant to apply for it. It's only students who receive an email. From Paris-Saclay University inviting them to apply for it will be able to submit application. So I think for this one, they invite you to apply for it if you're eligible. So first of all, our advice, you should look for a course first in this school. Check the timeline for the course application. Try and apply on time. When you're applying, put in your best foot, like give it your all, put in your best in your motivation letter, whatever thing. Just make sure you give it your best so that you'll be selected to apply for it. That's what I can advise. And then it says here the eligibility, that students admitted to Paris-Saclay University Master's Program delivered by one of the following institutions. So like some of these schools, they have different institutions under them, and I've listed the institution that you're eligible to apply. Then the maximum age of application is like 30 years, because the students age 30 and less during the course of the selection year. I mean, if you are beyond 30, you cannot apply for this one. Okay, so I think so. Just look at the eligibility, and the program fields is all academic fields are concerned, all master's program except vocational training. And it shows you the criteria, what is taken into consideration when they're evaluating you. So you see your academic level, your personal project, your specifically for students enrolled in M2, your motivation for pursuing a thesis in the laboratory or whatever thing. And then this is the amount you benefit from. So they will pay you 10,000 euros per year. And this is paid by the Paris-Saclay for the duration of the academic year. And they pay you like, I think maybe it's going to be like monthly for a period of 10 consecutive months. Maybe they are going to give you like 1,000 per year, per month, sorry, 1,000 per month. I think so, because that's what it's written here. Yeah, then they also give you a travel and visa expenses depending on your country of origin. I think it's similar to Erasmus, because Erasmus, too, when you get the scholarship, you actually want to process your visa. I think maybe they pay for one thing, they've forgotten. But by the time you reach the country where you are studying, they will now reimburse you depending on the distance, like the kilometers between your home country and the country you're starting your masters. They pay you, it could be up to like 3,000 euros or less than, or more than, I'm not really sure, but it actually depends on the distance between your home country and the country you're starting your first semester. So I think that's the same thing for this one too. And then the laureate will receive their scholarship as well as travel experience expenses, as well as travel expenses upon arrival. So most of these scholarships, you get it when you have arrived the country. So some of them, you have to like try to fund the money to pay your transportation to the country, and then now receive the reimbursement for it. So that is it. No advance payments can be made. You have to be there first. And you see other criterias and other terms and conditions for you to receive the scholarship, or when you have received the scholarship. So find out more through the link I'm going to share in the description. The next one we'll be looking at is Université Grenoble Alpes, and it's still similar to the IDEX masters, like the one in Université Paris-Saclay. It's still similar for it to it. And then you see the different schools that these scholarships cut across, and the faculty. So it's also for people for Grenoble IMP, that's the one I'm going to. And actually this IDEX scholarship is actually very few persons that are selected for it. So it's really, really competitive. Like if you don't get it, you don't feel bad. Don't think that maybe you did not that you're not good enough, because the opening is always very low. Like maybe for a class, they could actually just select only two persons for it. It's actually very, very, very competitive. And then for this one, and let's look at the timeline, the process. It's similar to the one of Paris-Saclay. So it's also the school that puts you in for the application. Like if you're interested in it, you automatically be registered to benefit from the scholarship. And they actually go through your qualification, your degree, and your reasons for studying, and so on, your academic level. And the application period is from March to July. That is for the one university going up apps. It's different from the one of Paris-Saclay. I think Paris-Saclay, it's finished around April. That's when the Paris-Saclay one finishes. So like I said previously, check your own school to see if they have the scholarships, and also check what is their own timeline. Not the timeline for it is very, very important. So unlike the one of Paris-Saclay where you are being paid 10,000 euros, for this one you are being paid 8,000 euros for one academic year. So for the two semesters, they give you 8,000 euros, and I think they pay it like in installments. I think maybe they give you like 4,000 the first time, they give you 4,000 the next time. So that is it. So if your school fees is like 5,000 euros, so this is enough for you. It's more than enough, like for the school fees, and they have 3,000 remaining for your accommodation. But then the thing is that for this IDEX scholarship, it's not automatic for the second year. So if you apply for the first year and you got it, doesn't mean that automatically you get it for the second year. You have to keep up with your academic level, and in the second year you have to apply again anew. And then in the second year, you know, it's not just you alone that is going to apply for it. Like it's not just people in your classes applying for it, because there are still some new students that are going to be newly registered for the second year. So it actually brings new competition for you. So it's not a guarantee that you're going to get it for the second year. But if you happen to get it for the second year, they'll pay you only 5,000 euros, because for the second year you only have just one semester and then 6 month internship. That's like 5 months of coursework or 4 months of coursework, and then you have 6 months internship. So the amount I pay you actually reduces. But I don't know why, because even the, it's not like the school fees is going to reduce. Even for the second year, you still end up paying like 5,000 euros if your school is for 5,000 euros in the first year. That is in the school I'm attending. I don't know for other schools, it'll be still the same thing. But maybe because you start earning from your internship, because here in France, most internships are paid. Just that maybe some that they pay you lower than some. That's just the only difference. But they pay for internships, yeah. For most of the internships. Okay, that is it for this scholarship. So for you to find more, you just have to apply to any of the Grenoble IMP schools, any of the UGR schools, and then if you meet up to the criteria for the scholarships, they automatically register you for it, and if you got it, they'll let you know. And like I said, take note of the timeline. So like the timeline for this one was between March to July of 2022. Timeline of 2023 is going to be between March 2023. Yeah, to July 2023. But first, you should remember to apply, because they're not the ones responsible for you to apply to the school. You first of all have to apply to the school before you are considered eligible to even apply for this scholarship. So take note of that. And that brings us to the end of today's video. I hope that this was useful to you, or this is going to be useful to you. Please, you have to put in the work to actually search for these schools, like search for the courses and learn more, or gain more knowledge on the eligibility, the timeline and everything, and then you put in your application. Thank you for watching thus far. See you in my next video. If you are here to like my videos, remember to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Bisous bisous et à bientôt. See you soon.